by there, aren't you?
Something soon if you can, Arthur.
Yeah, I will. That should be this bully stock.
It feels like now. Oh, I never normally
good
see
job,
it,
Mr.
Feels
Morgan.
Like now it's only a matter of time.
It'll be okay, miss.
Are you sure?
Reverend, you okay, Mr. Morgan?
I don't know, Reverend.
These are challenging times for all of us.
Yes, very challenging.
You don't seem yourself somehow. I've always felt... I've left the morphine, sir.
Arthur, Reverend Swanson, would you excuse us a minute?
Of course.
New York? We are going to go to New York. Now, they have been chasing us south and east and west. We're going to get a boat, we're going to get on a river, and we're going to go north.
New York.
Then Tahiti, the Fiji Islands, or this place, New Guinea, dancing girls, freedom. But first, we have to make a whole lot of smoke, a whole lot of commotion. And then we disappear.
We need more commotion?
One score and one whole hell of a lot of noise.
We ain't so good at doing scores anymore, Dutch.
Are you feeling all right, Arthur?
Sure, I'm fine.
Pardon me for interrupting. I brought a friend, Arthur.
Hello.
Hello.
Dutch, this is Eagle Flies. His father is a great chief. Charles and I,
pretended to be mercenaries. Did me a great favor.
Dutch Vanderlyn. How do you do?
Not well, sir.
Well, I am sorry to hear that.
How's your father?
Father has confused wisdom with weakness. His people, my people, we've suffered too much, been lied to too much. Now they've taken our horses.
Who?
The infantry division posted at Fort Wallace.
Why?
Colonel Favors is a liar and a murderer. His people won't stop until we're all dead. Without horses, we cannot hunt. Without hunting... we will starve. This is another act of war.
I see that.
Men have helped me before, and I have money.
Put your money away, son. What do you think, Charles?
You know I told your father I will not fight over some horses.
But I made no such promise. Come along.
Yeah. Arthur, we must go with them. To try to stop things from getting out of hand.
I guess. Come along.
We can get them more horses.
I know. I understand Eagle Flies is angry, but I don't see how this will help anything.
Especially not with Dutch whipping them up into a frenzy. Got enough folks coming after us without adding an army to the list.
You going to let these bastards walk all over you?
No. You're not. This is all that's wrong with this world.
Girl?
Okay, young man, lead the way.
The horses are on a boat near...
Fenrir,
I have a man waiting for us there with some canoes.
Surely... this can be done without killing anyone.
Of course! What will be, anyway, son, tell me about this Colonel Favors.
He's a vile man. danger of persecuting us. All the young have been taken from our reservation, shipped off to reform schools. Many women, too. The old are weak and sick, but they deliberately withhold medicine and supplies from us.
This ends today. You have my word on that.
Why are you getting involved in this, Dutch?
You know me. We shoot fellers as need shooting. We save fellers as need saving. Feed them as need feeding.
Not this again. It's been quite a while since we helped anyone but ourselves, and even you know that.
I told you, noise. We need noise, Arthur. Noise and faith.
I still don't know what that means.
Stop questioning and think. Just think for a second. The Pinkertons have had time to reinforce. The civilized world is closing on us. Who knows what else Molly told them? We need to move towards a conclusion now.
Sure, but what?
Might be just the distraction we need. Kill two birds with one stone. Cornwall was funding the Pinkertons' assault on us. Why do you think I dealt with him? With Cornwall gone, the government is far more likely to divert them to other issues, especially if there's one more scandal. And then we can slip away. Like I said, we just need that noise. And one more score. You know, I went back for the chest I had hidden outside Shady Bell. And we're close, Arthur. That dynamite, the railroad contract with the army, it was all in those papers Micah found. I have a plan. You just have to trust me.
There's Peta. These men, like I said, they'll help us.
I got the canoes. The boat is still moored in the channel.
Good. Let's wait until nightfall. All right. We can set out.
We need to get that boat ashore. I think the best plan is to paddle up there silently, board her. Then when we got control, we'll deal with that anchor, float away. We'll be ashore before anybody even knows what happened.
Try not to kill anyone, Arthur.
I'm gonna go smoke, all right? Be back in a bit.
Are confused. We need to round them up. I'll get these four, Arthur. Can you go after the others?
Okay. Over here. Come on. Come here.
Seems like Uncle Sam likes you fellas even less than he likes us.
So it goes. My father doesn't want to fight again. Will one of you help me return the horses to my men?
Well, Arthur... Oh, Arthur needs to rest. I will. I like you, son. And after the horses, are we going to wait for the army to come and wreak its revenge?
I hope not.
Of course we ain't. Now let's go check out that fort of theirs.
Is this a good idea?
This is the only idea. And it is one that will suit both of our purposes.
Fighting the army ain't wise.
Stop worrying. Oh, and Sadie told me about Cone. Meet us at Doyle's Tavern in Saint Denis when you can. Shall we go, son?
Certainly.
We'll start some light reconnaissance out at Fort Wallace, and when Combs dealt with, you come meet us there. We'll set up a good spot for you.
I don't know, Dutch.
Yeah, well, I do. This is exactly the distraction that we need.
Your father said that fighting was an impossible gamble. There's no winning for you in this.
Your father need not know anything. He'd rather live in ignorance.
Come along, gentlemen.
Your father would rather you did not do anything so foolish. I said I would stop this from happening. Would you talk to him?
Speak with Rangeful.
Yes. Would you?
Sure. I'll speak with him.
You head on back to camp, check on the others, Dutch's behavior. It's...
I understand.
Thank you, Arthur.
Let's go, girl.
How you doing?
Been thinking more about Dutch and Eagle Flies. It can only end badly.
There's only so much we can do about it.
Thank you.
Sorry, girl. Hey there, partner. Okay there.
mister.
Get down in my face.
Flies thinks this one may be of use, but he could bring us even more trouble.
Hey, folks.
I wouldn't stay around here too long if I was you.
Oh, well.
All right.
Hello?
Come in. You don't sound very well.
I'm not. I think I'm dying.
Then I hope you find peace.
Well, I don't know too much about peace.
Apparently not. Did you have fun with my son, the impetuous prince? I believe you went on a raid with him.
I'm sorry.
I suppose I lack the grandeur of a conventional king.
I don't know too many kings.
Colonel Favors, he has already exacted some measure of revenge for the raid. Two women were assaulted by his men.
Very sorry about all of this.
Yes. Sometimes the correct path, the bravest path, is the least obvious and also the gentlest. I'm a great disappointment to my son.
Your son seems to want a war.
My son thinks there is glory in death. Maybe he's right, but for me, I saw death being handed out so freely by the most foolish of men, I never could equate it with victory. Glory has come in service. Maybe. Maybe not, I don't know.
I've killed a lot of people. For a whole lot of dumb reasons, and I ain't never seen much glory in it.
Well, your friend, Mr. Vanderlyn, he talks a lot. I don't know him. But my son is easily led.
I'm not sure I get you.
Well, perhaps we could go for a ride. I'm an old man. My whole life I have tried to bring peace.
But I ain't doing so good.
Then maybe you can take pity on my plight. Please, it won't take long. And maybe I can help you with that cough.
Sir! I'm glad I caught you, sir.
Captain Monroe, do you know my friend, Mr. Morgan?
No, sir. I don't have the pleasure.
Arthur Morgan.
It's an honor, sir.
How can I help you, Captain?
I was just in Saint-Denis. I spoke with the mayor. It's not good news, I'm afraid. May I ride with you for a little?
Of course.
Follow me.
So where are we going?
I want to show you a sight up in the... mountains that's long been sacred to me. A place for reflection and healing. What is this news, Captain Monroe?
Yes, sir. As I mentioned, I did speak again with the mayor and the Bureau of Indian Affairs in Saint-Denis at length. But regrettably, it appears the oil company has already received approval to move forward with drilling on the reservation's land.
I suppose there's much. So what does that mean for us now?
I'm not sure just yet. I didn't get the impression anything would be happening for a few months. I'm very sorry, sir. I did everything I could.
I know, Captain.
And I assure you I will continue to do as much as I can. Mr. Morgan, would you have time to help me at all? I would rather certain actions were taken by friends outside the tribe. I'm sorry to be bored, but there's so much to be done. So I should take this as a yes?
Yeah.
Anyway, gentlemen, I won't take up any more of your time. I'll see you both soon.
Sure.
Thank you, Captain.
Enjoy the ride.
We'll continue on this way. I'm going to look for some herbs to give you.
Yeah.
Too well, but I wanted to speak to you about your son. I was there on the raid to steal back those horses, and, well, you know something of Dutch, I think.
Yes, a little. Sorry, hold up a moment. That'll have to wait. Some of the plants I need will be growing down here. This is what I was looking for. English mace. Okay, let's continue on.
Like you were saying before.
Yes, a little. Mostly from your friend Charles.
I don't know why Dutch is getting involved in your situation, and this ain't easy to say, but I just don't trust that he's got your son's best interests at heart.
So what can we do?
I don't rightly know. Charles and I just thought you should be aware. Maybe there's a way to stop things from getting any more out of control.
Thank you, Mr. Morgan. Let me give this some thought.
Things that bad on the reservation?
Yes. This conflict with Colonel Favors and his regiment at Fort Wallace continues to worsen. Many of the elders are sick, and the young feel that any compromise is an admittance of defeat.
Well, we ain't done much to calm the situation.
but I have to continue to seek to resolve matters through peaceful negotiation. War would be futile.
Your people are lucky to have you.
I'm not so sure about that. Wait, stop here. I want to pick some ginseng. This will combine well. Wait there. I'll put these in your saddlebag. Let's go. It's not much further now.
And that fella, Monroe, how you know him? Anyway, what was you talking about?
Captain Monroe was reassigned here from a regiment in the north. Apparently, the news of our conflict has spread all the way to Washington. He's a good man. He wants to help.
Well, I guess that's something at least.
The army aren't all bad men, just as my people aren't all good. But this Colonel Favors, he walks an old line. He's obstinate and he hates Monroe. I just hope between us we can work this out. It's just up ahead.
What's happened? No! It can't be. No! They destroyed everything! I need to find the Chinupa. Who would do this?
Someone who wanted to enrage you.
Help me look around, please. The Chinupa is gone.
Of course. What is it?
A ceremonial pipe. There must be some clues to what happened here.
There's some whiskey here.
Okay. Let me give this some more thought. Thank you, Mr. Morgan.
empty bottle of whiskey.
Well, if they drank all that, they couldn't have gotten too far.
Yeah, well, still no sign of the Chinupa.
Rangefall, over here. I think I see an army camp.
Oh, there they are. These brave men. Some of Colonel Favor's men. They must have been the ones who did this.
Are you surprised this happened?
Not at all. But I hope we were past this.
Well, you got land they want. Land with oil.
They moved us here. They've taken everything we had. I signed 3 treaties myself, and they've broken each one. No, they've taken... Oh. Now my people are going to want a war. A war they can't win.
Not if I get it back.
Get it back?
Yeah, I'm gonna go in, get your chin up, and no one will be any the wiser.
Would you do that?
Well, you can't go. They know why you'd come.
I don't have any money.
No, I don't need your money.
Please see if they have our sacred items. But try not to hurt anyone.
I'll try to ensure that they never even know I'm there, but actions don't always go the way you plan.
For the Chinupa. If you could do this for me, I would very much... appreciate it. Are you not going down there?
Easy there.
silly, though.
I know. Who wants to fight them?
Who cares?
What's got this horse food, huh?
Come on, my girl. Yeah.
Please tell me you found it.
Here. I got your things, I think.
Yes. Thank you.
I'm very sorry about this.
Even Sacred things are only things. People, the heart, matter more. Was anyone hurt?
Yes.
It's a bad business. I should not have let you do this for me. But perhaps it will stop a bigger massacre. With these, maybe I can calm my people. Maybe I can calm my son.
I hope so.
Thank you. Take those herbs I gave you, please. And most of all, I hope you can find peace within yourself.